Hey guys, in this video we are going to merge data from different Excel files. The tricky part is that the header names are different within each workbook. Let me explain this. I have four Excel files in my folder with employee data for different countries. So I've got one file for Germany, Spain, Italy and the US. Let me open up the file from Germany. The data itself is stored in an Excel table called T-Salary. The header of this table is written in German. So, Gehalt means salary and Abteilung means department. Also, if we look at the other files, we can see that the table name, so T-Salary, is unchanged. However, the header names are in the respective language of the country. I intend now to combine all tables into one master file and use English for the header names. In fact, one of my YouTube subscribers suggested this video idea. He watched a video from Layla. In that video, Layla was merging the files by using Power Query. However, he wanted to know if we could also do it in Python. So that is the reason I have created a Python solution to solve this task. That said, if you are interested in the Power Query solution, I will leave the link to Layla's video in the description below. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. First things first, I'm going to install the required dependencies. For this project, I will use Pandas and Excelwings. You can install those modules by typing pip install pandas and Excelwings in your command prompt or terminal. Once we've gotten that out of the way, I will open up a blank Python file. The first step is to import the libraries. As we are also dealing with different file paths, I'm also importing path from pathlib. Pathlib is a standard Python module and was introduced with Python 3.4. Therefore, no extra installation is required. Additionally, I will import pandas as pd and excelwings as xw. Next, I will specify the input directory that contains the different Excel files. In my case, the folder is called input and is located in the same working directory, so the parent directory of my Python file. With that in place, I will create a list that contains the Excel file paths. I will use globe on the input directory to make this list and specify that I'm only looking for Excel files. Before iterating over that list, I will set up the mapping table for the different headers. So, as an example, the German name Abteilung should be translated to department. And with that in place, I will create an empty list and call it data frames. In just a moment, I will show you what we are going to do with that list. Next, I'm initializing the Excel instance. By setting visible to false, Excel will start in the background. Then I'm going to loop over each file and open up the workbook. In our example files, the table with the data is located in the first worksheet, so at index position 0. Within that sheet, I want to convert the table to a pandas data frame, rename the headers, add a source column, and append it to our data frames list. So, first, let me transform the table into a pandas data frame. This transformation is pretty straightforward in Excelwings. You just need to specify the table name and provide the desired output in the options. In our case, we want to convert it to a pandas data frame without the index. This data frame contains the original header. So, before merging the data frame, I want to rename the column headers based on our mapping table. Additionally, I will add a new column to display the source name, so our file name. With pathlib, we can use stem to return the file name and not the full path. Once we have our final data frame, I will append it to our data frames list and close the workbook. I will now merge all single data frames into one master data frame. I will call this data frame combined underscore df. To join the data frames, you just need to type pd.concat followed by the list of data frames. To export our master data frame, I will create a new workbook. This fresh workbook will look like this. In my case, I would like to export the data frame to the first worksheet, starting from cell A1. As the last step, I will save our workbook to the current working directory, so the parent directory of this Python file. Once done, I will close the workbook. And that is all there is to it. Let me execute our script and check out the new Excel file. I will insert a filter on our data to validate that it worked. As we can see, all four files have been merged. Okay guys, and that is all for this tutorial. If you also have other use cases or video ideas, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.